Dobrý deň, vážení občania, vypočujte si nasledovný oznam. Súkromný predajca z Galanty, kolo sa na
I don't know where it's coming from. It's the church. I wonder what religion they are. Oh, there it is. I see it.
Uvedený tovar si môžete zakúpiť o 7,50. Pôjde biela dodávka smerom z dola nahor a zastaví občanom na znamenie.
That must have been, I don't know, ceremony for the entire city. So they can go on with their day in a blessed manner, I guess. Yeah, I guess you need that. Who doesn't need that? What it's saying is we have 8.5 kilometers of incline left. And a total of 357 meters of altitude. It's gonna be fun, right?
Sure.
My heart rate is freaking rocking around the Christmas tree.
Thank you, Hill, for keeping me strong.
Okay, this is the last bit. And I'll cross the top of the mountain and the border to Slovakia, I think.
That was good.
Slovenská republika.
We end up spending only a modest 3 days in the Czech Republic. And that actually makes us a little sad, because we had a real good time there. But three things made us pick up the pace. First, we found a place called Sudov Rocks. The person who told us about it called it the Slovak Dolomites, and obviously we have to go there. Then we got accepted by a warm showers host in the city of Žilina, and every chance we get to meet some local people is a bit of a treasure. And finally, we have a new plan cooking, and it's pulling us straight south. Having never been to the non-Slovak Dolomites, we can't be the judges of potential similarities. But this two-person jury only needs one evening to rule that this place does indeed rock.
This is great.
Back in the city of the mass blessings, we prepare to ride an on-the-surface simple 15 kilometers to Žilina.
We're gonna go up and around those crazy rocks.
We do have a strong suspicion, though, that this might be a very technical day on the bikes.
We managed to stay on the bikes for 300 meters. Then we pulled the bikes on a very muddy trail. But it seems now that the trail will favor the bikes. The trail roughened up, and it's not exactly bikeable anymore.
With an equal amount of pushing and pedaling, we make it to the top. And while we expected to get some fairly spectacular views from up here, reality is generous today and exceeds our expectations.
I think it's all downhill to Žilina from here. What are you doing in there, bastard?
My hands are cramping from holding the brakes.
We go out of the forest and onto the fields, and finally into the city. In Žilina, we spend some time and try a local beverage before we meet up with our host.
I'm excited about what you think.
Это вот. Как это?
It's like a little bit cinnamon, a little bit lime.
Hello, I'm Marian, and I'm from Slovakia.
City bike.
Yeah, love it.
I really like the way people live here, and people can be really nice if they are in mood.
This is all Slovakian brand, like...
It's Slovakian brand?
Yeah, Czechoslovakian, yeah.
Oh, sweet.
It's called Favorite.
Okay.
Like favorite.
Yeah.
Is Slovakia your favorite place in the world to bike?
Yeah, it's nice to bike in Slovakia, but I dream about cycling in Italy.
Nice meeting you.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah. Hope to see you in
Copenhagen or maybe Italy.
Maybe.
Thank you. It was really, really nice.
Yeah. Last night we asked Marian what the deal is with the church's mass blasting blessings on everybody.
And I showed him the film and he translated it. Turns out they were talking about a van going through the city to sell potatoes and other vegetables, and yeah, basically they were advertising what was going to happen during the day.
Talk about being confidently wrong. However, blessings come in various formats, and the beauty of this country is definitely one. Our journey across Slovakia is going to take us through 4 cities in 4 days. And we get a great start riding on yet another set of beautiful forest roads. Soon thereafter though, reality checks in pretty hard when we end up on a busy main road.
On that busy road, did you have like near-death experience feeling?
The motorists here seem to occupy the more aggressive end of the temperament spectrum. And while that in itself can be rather scary, some truck drivers here seems to be possessed by a whole new level of malevolence. That's absolutely terrifying. We calm our nerves with a second breakfast at Macca's. And while Macca's certainly don't define any nation's cuisine, we do attempt to get a grasp on what constitutes Slovak food.
So the mission is to try local food in each country. And this is potato dumplings with some bacon and spring onions and sauerkraut. And it's pretty good.
We are trying to stick to a budget though, so we mostly buy our food in the local supermarkets. So maybe we don't get the strongest sense of Slovak food. We do, on the other hand, become quite fluent in the food side of the language.
Hot doggy, burgery, drinky. Quite a bit of detail to plan this route so we don't have to go on big roads. So far it's checked out. We've been on small roads through small villages all day.
The Slovaks seems to like their animals. And they seem to be treating them quite well. And people who treat animals well are the best kind of people. These two goes into the history books as some of our favorite animal friends ever. More than anything, our time in Slovakia is defined by the many beautiful mountains we have crossed. This is going to be the last one in a while, and it's a beast of a mountain.
We just had 500 meters
of up, and then Henrik, and he looks back at me and tells me, now the 5K up starts.
I got the sideburns, the f***ing scissors thing. This is the roughest hill so far. I can barely keep the bike moving.
On the other side of the mountain, the rain is intensifying a bit, so we take a break around 5 kilometers from our destination.
Kanelsnurre.
Cinnamon bun.
Yeah, cinnamon bun. And I'm so hungry and it smells delicious.
Tomorrow, at this time, we'll be in Hungary.
The rain turns down the volume again, and we get a window of sunshine to do the final jump to the place where we're gonna spend our last night here in Slovakia.
This place is very cool. And the people we're staying with are very nice.
Finally came. Good thing we are in here.
Day 74 dawns and it's full of all the things we like the most. A goodbye fanfare from the street speakers. Bus drivers that give a damn and try to keep us safe. A bridge to a new country.
Oh, there it is.
And best of all, a warm welcome to Hungary from two cute dogs. Tomorrow we're going in the same direction as the Danube River, Budapest. We follow a surprisingly bike-friendly path most of the way to the city. When we arrive, we go out and behave like normal tourists for a while.
50,000 hoof.
And then we prepare to celebrate.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
The rain catches up with us again, so we take shelter at a bar. Here we make new friends from our true sister nation, the Netherlands. And finally, our new plan is done cooking. And at the end of the day, we make a big decision.
Today, we decided. 20 days from now, we'll be in South Korea.
Is 안녕하세요.
It's about the food, the fun, and the friendship.
So relieved.
So incredibly relieved.
This is a drive-in motel.
I definitely recommend you this passport.
We're from South Africa.
What's your name?
Richard.
We were just brought to the police station by the Korean police and military.